The following is a short recorded presentation on how to sample disease material for pathogen identification via the Disease Diagnostic Clinic. Firstly, identify the tissue that display the symptoms. This could be nuts, flowers, leaves, branches, or roots. Take pictures of the symptoms that you observe in the field and share this with us. For sampling, it's always important to sterilize both your hands as well as the tools that you will use to take the sample. Place the samples in brown paper bags. If you are making use of plastic or Ziploc bags, please add small holes for ventilation. Thereafter, label each of the sample bags, complete the online submission form, and courier the samples overnight. In the following slides, we will look at specific tissue types, starting with nuts. It is, however, important to note that the principle for sampling will remain the same. To start off with nuts, only collect nuts that are still directly attached to the tree, preferably between 5 and 10. Collect nuts that has got both healthy as well as diseased tissue, so in other words, a combination of green as well as black-brown lesions, all of that being on the same nut. Never submit nuts that is already laying on the orchard floor, and also severely diseased nuts, so in other words, no healthy tissue on the nut, really limits our ability to identify the primary causal agent. This is because a number of secondary fungi will already be growing with the primary causal agent. If we focus on flowers, please collect racemes that are still attached to the tree. And again, severely diseased material or completely dry material cannot be used for the identification of the primary causal agent. The following are then pictures of leaf samples that we can really use to identify the causal agent of this specific disease. Compared to dried leaves or leaves on the orchard floor that we can no longer use. The same is also true for branches, with this slide representing suitable samples that can be submitted versus a sample that we can no longer use to positively identify the causal agent. The last two slides is just some information on how to sample roots. To start off, always remove the organic material. When you send in roots, please also add some of the soil with the root sample. Please make sure that you collect both roots and soil from all four sides of the tree that is at least 30 to 50 centimeters away from the tree trunk. These should then be combined as a single sample, and that should at least be 500 grams.